Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making pecan pie bars, and it's a favorite of my family. We have it at almost every holiday celebration, so I want to show it to you. It starts out with a yellow cake mix, just a standard size yellow cake mix. This is actually a golden butter recipe. It doesn't matter, just as long as it's a yellow cake. And what you're going to do is pour out 2/3 of a cup of that mix, and you're going to set it aside. It'll be used later, so we need to keep it separate from all of this, which is going to be a crust that we're making actually for the bottom. So I'm going to get into my cake mix here, and this is what is left of it. Put it in a big mixing bowl. To this I'm going to add some margarine. You can use butter or margarine. And you need to have it melted. And this is cooled off and everything. I've melted it. This is 1 stick or 1/2 cup of melted margarine. So that's going to go in there. And there's one additional thing before we mix this up. And that is 1 beaten egg. I have this egg that's prepared. It's well beaten. And we're going to put it in our mix, and then just take a fork and mix this around. It's going to be a little crumbly, but our purpose is to put it in a large pan like this. This is a 13x9x2 Pyrex dish, and when you get this crust ready, then you can just press it with your fingers or with a spoon onto the bottom. And then that is going to be cooked separately from the rest of the dish. The rest of the dish is going to be on top of it. So we'll start out by making this bottom crust. I'm going to just start getting this prepared by bringing this out. We need to just start spreading that. And it's not that easy to do with the fork. So I'm just going to use my hands. So this will take a few minutes. Let me go away and get this done. And you can see it spreads pretty easily, but I'll be back and show you the spread crust. The crust is all spread out and ready. So now I'm going to put this in a 350-degree oven, and it will start to brown up, and I will take it out when it's just lightly brown. And that might be about 12 to 15 minutes. We'll see. I'll let you know. The crust is ready, and you can see this is the degree of doneness that I want. It's really light, but it's beginning to brown a bit. This is going to go back in the oven, so I'm not trying to get it dark brown. What I need to do now is to work on a topping that will go over this. So let's go over here and see what we have left to work with. Remember that 2/3 of a cup of reserved yellow cake mix? Let's put it in a large mixing bowl. Have beaten 3 eggs, just regular eggs. These are jumbo, it doesn't matter. 3 eggs, and that will go in next, along with the reserved cake mix. And next we have some brown sugar. This is light brown sugar, and I've measured out 1/2 cup. So we're going to bring 1/2 cup and put that in. It's firmly packed. And the next thing is some dark Karo syrup. And I use just about all of this. This is 1 1/2 cups. I've got one more thing after this. And I'll need to add my Karo syrup. And remember to get the dark kind. There is a light syrup and there's a white syrup. We want the dark Karo syrup. That goes in. And the very last thing, not the very last thing in the recipe, but the very last thing before I start mixing this is vanilla. And I have 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract. So now we can mix. So I'm mixing with a spoon, and what I need to do is just get it to the point where it's blended, and then I'm going to beat it with the mixer for 2 minutes. So why don't I go away and do that, and I'll come back ready to continue with the recipe. Now my mixture is all beaten, and it's ready to go over the top of our crust, our partially cooked crust. This looks quite a lot like pecan pie. I do have a pecan pie recipe in Betty's Kitchen if you're interested. I think I called it Very Southern Pecan Pie. It's really good. But this is a different consistency. These make bars instead of pies. And we're not quite done yet because there is one last ingredient, which is the pecans. It wouldn't be much of a pecan bar if it didn't have pecans in it. So we have 1 whole cup of, these are called fancy pecan pieces. Just think of them as chopped pecans. You could put halves of pecans on there if you want. But I reserve those for pecan pies because I go through and turn them all over to make them very pretty. And this, being a bar, doesn't really need that extra attention. So just try to evenly sprinkle out your pecans over the top. And then you'll be putting this back in the oven at 350 degrees, and it will cook for a more significant amount of time. It'll probably be close to a half hour, somewhere around there. But I'll let you know the time when I get it out of the oven. So I'll be back then. Our pecan pie bars are done. And you can tell that they're done when they're nice and golden, a little bit brown on the top. And you should be able to take a toothpick and put it in the center and it come out clean. And if that happens, then you know you can take your pecan pie bars up. So we're putting those on the counter, turning the oven off. And what these do now is sit. They sit for probably about 4 hours or so to cool off. When they are cool, then I can cut them into bars. So I'll be back later to show you the dish where I have pecan pie bars. It's been about 4 hours since I took my pecan pie bars out of the oven. And after about 1 hour of cooling, I put plastic wrap over the top, and then I just let them set for 3 more hours. And it's time to serve them up. So I have a nice plate here, and I just pick a line across here that I want to cut, and then I cut it in 3 sections. You may have some different format that you like, but you go under it with a fork and dig it out. And these are going to be kind of crumbly and kind of gooey also, but they're delicious. They're really worth the effort of making and also of digging them out of this pan. That's what they look like. Looks great. So we'll just put that down in there. And then coming across that line that I just formed, there's another one. There's space for it there. And then here's another one. And a space for it here.